Expert here trying to hijack this video with our new Kickstarter campaign for our awesome smartphone seat post sender.
Oh, seat down, eh? Oh, Wade Simmons, Huck.
Just tell your phone where to put the seat and Siri does the work.
In this video, we'll show you how to change that old SRAM front shifter into a dropper post switch. Now, each shifter is a little bit different than the others, but the general internal designs are all pretty much the same. Now, before you dive in, you need to make sure that you have a dropper post that will be compatible with this switch. You need a dropper post that's made to have the cable head installed in the switch rather than in the post. Examples of compatible posts are the Kineshock Lev and the second generation Kineshock Lev Integra with this style of cable attachment assembly at the bottom, and all versions of the specialized command post. Now let's look at the shifter we're modifying. Here's a SRAM X5 shifter that we've already done, but I'll run through the process step by step with this SRAM X7 2x10 speed front shifter. But any SRAM front trigger shifter can be modified using essentially the same instructions. Let's get started. First, remove the top cover and remove the secondary return spring on top of the shifter mechanism. At this point, it's a good idea to use a set of vice grips to clamp the shifter mechanism to the shifter body so that it doesn't separate. Otherwise, you may have to rebuild the bottom end of the shifter as well if it falls apart. Then use a pair of 5mm Allen wrenches to remove the bolt that is holding the shifter internals to the cable uptake lever. Now remove the plastic cable pulley assembly. At the base of this assembly is a metal plate with teeth on the edges that serve as an indexing mechanism in the shifter. These teeth need to be removed. Remove the metal plate from the shifter. Now use a bench grinder or a file to remove the tooth on this side, including these two lobes. Once you've removed the tooth and lobes, deburr the new edges so that they don't cause drag when moving inside the shifter. Now we can turn our attention to cutting off the cable release button. Now this next step isn't necessary, but I like to do it to make the finished product look a little bit more pro. Remove the pivot pin holding the release button into the shifter. Then pop the button up and out of the top of the shifter. Clamp the shifter into a vise and then use a hacksaw or Dremel cutoff wheel to cut the button flush with the shifter body. Clean up the cut edge with a bench grinder, file, or sandpaper. Reinstall the switch, being careful to put the return spring back in the way it was so that the button doesn't rattle. Then slide the pivot pin back in. Now I can finish reassembling the top end of the shifter. Reinstall the plate onto the plastic cable pulley and apply grease to the plate so that it slides smoothly inside the shifter. Line up the wide slot in the plate with the tab protruding up from the cable uptake lever. Then reinstall the main bolt followed by the secondary return spring. Reinstall the shifter cover screws and check your work to make sure that the switch functions smoothly and without any rattles. You now have a killer dropper post switch that didn't cost you a dime and that you can be proud that you made yourself.